tracks. Now we have to put something on the track, so.
This old trolley.
This old trolley, right. And this is a recycled, reborn a trolley part here. Anyway, this is the basic side frame for a single truck trolley. And we're, we made one side, and we're going to duplicate it for the other side here. Copy the same measurements off, we'll be okay. Okay, let's see if that's set. We use the pragmatic approach. If it looks right, we use it. Now, looks like this is parallel here. Oh, not quite yet.
And the newly assembled base. Here's a close-up of the wheel with the new rims.
Yeah.
Spot welded around the edges to hold them in place.
Come over here and see the particular type of plumbing. Here's a cap, end cap over a reducer. I'm not sure, it's a 1.5 inch to 1 3/4 inch. And then the spring in here is made from or cut from an old overload shock from our Ford van. We don't know exactly if it's going to be adequate or, but at least it's a starting point. Putting these rims on here have brought the flange more into a line to a realistic flange, which is just fine because we had to that gave us more room to play with the actual truck itself to beef up the wheel. Now starting to accumulate some weight now. We're not gonna roll this over our head. Once we get the motor and the body on here, this is gonna be a nice job on here. Now let's see. See how this thing rolls. Well, that sounds pretty good. Take it down the track here. Okay. I think we'll go for a little ride. The basis of a trolley. So, see you at the bottom of the hill.
Real nice and smooth, nice sound.
Switch isn't exactly in the best position, but at least it rolls.
How you doing? Hey. Shoes on the wheels, use his brake. Up into the frog, where it loses it.
Flip the switch.
Looking at the car, we don't have the front panel on yet. Over here, take a better view of everything. Take a look at the canvas roof here. As we come along, so we got our bell installed in there.
We got the pole. We got a little hook on here to keep the when the pole comes off the wire. At least it can't go much further than that. Keeps it from snagging. I had already had a bent pole one time. I'm going to roll this back here just to give you an idea how it rolls. Stay onto the pavement here. This is push power. Okay. You can see how it looks with the bricks here. It'll look pretty realistic here. Two poles with the clinger or a dinger, donger or whatever. We're going to take it up the hill here. We're going to roll back down. Take a ride down. I as long as it's downhill.
You have the house here. She's the one that has to tolerate all this trolley nonsense here. What's your reaction to this?
It's cute.
It's cute. Doesn't that remnant bring back all the memories of the good old days?
I didn't know those good old days.
You didn't know those good old days. Okay. July 2nd, and we're looking at the trolley barn as it looks right now. We have reconstructed the front end of the car, so it's a little wider, looks more realistic. Okay, as we look over, we can see some of the brake work in there. It's actually a wooden shoe pushed on by a beam, and it seems to work fairly well on a hill too. Again, you can see the track work, or at least the switch work here, you can see is made from various types of angle irons, primarily pieces of stop sign post cut in half, and then regular farm fence posts welded to it. Okay, this is a double switch point here. We had to go to a double point. I had problems with the single point. I had a single point on that side. You can see the mechanism for throwing it from one position to another. The rod goes from the two nail holes over to the next two nail holes, and then that opens the switch for a different position. Okay, again, looking up the right-of-way. This is becoming a little bit more difficult to keep the weeds from accumulating. One of the problems, of course, is that things grow very fast when they're exposed to the sun. And so once you get some of the weeds out there, the grasses grow like crazy. So it's always nice to take a view of the work from an unusual angle. Here you can see the particular trolley hangers, the construction of the hangers that hold the wire up. Just pieces of metal folded around. Okay, the wire that holds it up. And the posts here, regular trolley posts. Again, looking at the car from various angles, looking down the right of way. You see the sag of the wire here, holding up the wire.
It's about a number 8 copper wire right now.
Get over here and take a look at the motor a little bit better. The motor is, and we zoom in there. Got a double gear now. And I'm trying to get it to stay put. This is a 2-horsepower motor now instead of 1-horsepower. Plenty of zip in it. Trolley pole is off. Over here, look at the handle. There we are. That controls the mechanism, reverser.
The end of the present line here.
Temporary end here. Right. So we can get some more hardware here. Okay, here we go for the next.
Just about to transfer this old trolley to this old truck. And here's the transfer crew. Fletcher's going to supervise.
Fletcher, we're going to put it on your back and you're going to walk it up on the truck.
Okay. So let's see what it looks like up here. All right, here's the truck, and here's the arrangement on here. We'll see. See if you think it'll. If we run it real hard, you think it'll jump from one end to the other?
Let's try.
Okay. Well, that should I make a ramp or shouldn't I? That is the question. This old trolley is on this old truck right now. We have two old trolley hands here. To
the old man.
Okay, experienced trolley operators here. All right, supervised by. Okay, there we go. Now this is going to be here, I hope. Well, let's see what'll happen when it goes down the road.
Down more here.
What's this here? What color, huh? You're gonna wipe it off. We just got it off the truck here. There we go.
This is them carrying the truck.
Okay, this is a imitation street. This is a little faster, quite a bit faster than making each into the brick. Just take a mold. Look how nice and clear that came up.
Yeah, that's good.
I just put it in there.
It's really cute.
Set it in there. Give it a good old wiggle and jiggle. Here we go.
And you get a little irregularities that you want.
Right, it kind of bubbles up a little bit, see?
Yeah.
Now? Because that's where it ended the other one, but I mean, streets, that's what the character of streets are like. Yeah. See how far the trolley's gone over there? You swing it around down here. Now I'm gonna take out these, this corner one and that one over there. I'm gonna put them over there. They're just growing.
Oh, you transplanted some over there.
Yeah, well, yeah, see, the ones I took out.
And this is the start of the trolley line here. This is the trolley barn here, and we continue on, heading into the woods. This is Grunwald.
Coming.
And we're furthest in into the woods. The last stop before it curves around. Back. Switch.